In part one, I showed what we're doing these calculations to determine confidence intervals, where we're doing first a nonlinear regression, determine the two parameters for the rate expressions, case the rate constant and the activation energy. Here I just want to show, using the Excel spreadsheet, how we enter the information and the equations in Excel. So the first thing that's important, we already showed, if we look at this cell, this is the partial of the rate constant with respect to K0 that we see the equation on top here. What we've done is we've selected all of these cells, and then we've named this X. So by selecting all the cells and putting the name up in the corner here, we've named this as an array, a matrix. So now I want to do this matrix calculation, and it's important first I select the cells, so we end up with 2x2 matrix, and then I'm going to type in equation here. I'm going to pause while I do that typing. So I've entered the equation, and now select Control-Shift-Enter, so it enters the values into this matrix, and then remember our calculations are that this is just the square of this standard error up here. This is the square root of G21, which is this cell, times this term here. This is the square root of H22, this cell, again times this. Alpha 5%, and this is from the T distribution. And then we calculate the intervals down here. So you can see it's the T value from the T distribution times this term we calculated from this matrix that resulted from the multiplication. And so then we can see that we have confidence intervals. It's just at least small, a little more than 10% of the K value. And now the activation energy, the confidence limit, you notice, is a very small fraction of the value. Looks like if we look at here, compare it in kilojoules, it's about 4.5% of the activation energy. And then finally calculated the pre-exponential factor, as we mentioned in the first screencast. Since K0 is the rate constant evaluated at T0, 770 Kelvin, pre-exponential factor is what we would typically use in subsequent calculations or modeling of the kinetics in a reactor, for example. So now we've seen in these series of screencasts how to use Solver to calculate parameters for activation energy and pre-exponential factor, and then how to determine confidence limits using Excel.